I'm the guy who basically gets all this mess started for these guys. I'm their commanding general. I'm in charge of the operation in Iraq, this fictional operation that they have to go and do. I try to talk Hannibal out of it, but he insists, and I go along with it finally, and he does it with my orders and with my approval. And I'm not going to give anything else away.
But now, did you have to be in any of the action scenes and the dangerous stuff?
At my age? Come on, my idea of action is a rocking chair. Give me a break. No, I didn't do much of anything in the way of action.
Sad loss today of Rue McClanahan.
I worked with Rue. She was a sweetheart. Just one of the finest ladies you'd ever want to meet in your life.
Why?
A huge talent. But again, one of those people who was just so down to earth, you just wanted to sit and chat with her. And I'm going to miss her. Ending an era of those actresses who were, had all that talent and were just as humble as you could possibly imagine. And just good people.
Good people, hard workers.
Yeah. Yeah, always there on time, always prepared, professionals.
And what shows did you guys do together?
Well, she came on and did an episode of a show called Promised Land that I did. And it was just, she was a brilliant actress.
Now, was she at all like her character, like kind of flirty and
no.
fun, no?
Oh, no, she was great fun. But, no, she played some characters from time to time that were sort of airheads.
Yeah.
Rue was no airhead.
Yeah.
Not at all.
You know, it's funny, she was one of the original...
She was a great broad.
Yeah, a great broad.
And
that's
she
great.
Would not be mad at me for using that word.
Yeah.
She was
that's a compliment.
A great broad.
Yep. A lady and a great broad.
Yeah.
Now, she was actually one of the original cougars, you know? It's sort of like, I think I look at Samantha Jones on Sex and the City and I kind of see flashes of Blanche Devereaux.
Yeah.
I mean, if it wasn't for Blanche, we wouldn't have Sex and the City.
Probably not.
Yeah.
Probably not.
Yeah.
But those ladies, you know, their demographic was odd. Their biggest demographic was with young girls. So it proves, I think, that if you do something and do it well, that it appeals to a broad spectrum of people. It wasn't just the old people who liked Golden Girls. Kids love that show.
And I still TiVo it. And I watch 2 or 3 episodes a week.
Well, I watch it all the time myself.
Yeah, it just makes you feel good.
It's great. It's great.
Well, you look fantastic tonight. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Can't wait to see you in the film.
Thanks a lot.